working late one night on his latest batch of home brew. Mild-mannered meteorologist Warren Parks discovered a yeast infection had infiltrated his infusing amber fluid.
Oh no, over-fermentation.
Which can only result in... Drenched in the badly brewed beverage, our hero forecasts a change.
Energy draining, apathy building, mullet growing.
Then, rising from the settled suds was the man the world needs, Bloke Man.
But I don't work Sundays or me day off.
Release the hostages and come out with your hands up. You will not be harmed. I repeat, you will not be harmed.
Domino from Fire Chief.
Wait for my signal. Christ, where's a low-level, locally-based superhero when you need one?
G'day, Chief, baby. What do you know?
Madam, would you please stand behind the police lines?
Chief, that's a bloke. And not just any bloke, man. It's me, Bloke Man.
Bloke Man?
Please, say mon nom. Ne wear it out, pas. I've been taking French classes.
That shirt, those sunglasses.
And is that Acqua di Gio by Armani? Cool Water by Davidad. But you were close.
I never thought I'd say this, Bloke Man, but what happened to the durries? The variable hygiene standards, the UDL breath, the
arse sweat stained tights.
Thank you, I knew I was forgetting something.
Oh, you can forget that, Gauchery. I've hung up the uggies and gone and joined the other side. Ever since Wondermile's been going around with that punce metrosexual man, I've realised if you can't beat him, join him. And if that means switching from Snags and VB to salt-crusted swordfish with low-carb beer, so be it.
In the name of all that's holy, no woman's worth it, Bloke Man.
Oh, this isn't for a woman. This is for the most important person in every metrosexual's life. Himself, me. The Aussie bloke's on the way out. You've got to be cosmopolitan to keep a woman these days. Zhuzh the hair, clean the teeth.
But that's so... So
gay in every way except for sexual orientation, I know. Now, if you'll excuse me, I hear tell of an outstanding little hand cream boutique around here somewhere.
But there's a robbery. There's hostages.
Oh, please, Chief. These cuticles are the real victims here.
Bloke Man, I don't want to come down hard on you, but your benefits depend on...
Chieflet, I'm not on the dole anymore. Welfare's for Labour voters and other losers. Now, I've got a job selling iPods in the city. Now, if you'll excuse me... I must away.
Bloke Man's abandoned us.
The prick!
There's no sign of metrosexual man either. Something's afoot. Hand me the phone.
Well, Chief, enchanté to hear from you.
Metrosexual man, there's a robbery occurring downtown. I need you down here.
Well, I'd love to help, Chief, but I'm afraid I have my Pilates class to teach. Then with my flamingo lessons at 8... And also my anal bleach.
Metrosexual man, you must listen to me.
Now you listen to me, Fatfoot. And me soon to be a supplier of sexual services to Wondermole. And Bloke Man himself gone all Wagyu beef and Pinot on you. From now on, every time you want me to save this city, it's gonna cost you 5 G's.
$5,000? That's preposterous.
Those are my terms. Now if you'll excuse me, Wondermole and I have an Iranian film premiere to attend. Oh, do get your feet off the table, my dear. What did I tell you about eating in the living room? It's really most unbecoming.
You're friggin' joking, right?
I knew it. That Campari-quaffing metrosexual man's zhuzhed-up capital city's only true superhero, Bloke Man. And now he's holding us all to ransom.
What are we gonna do?
I never thought I'd say this, but we need to get the old Bloke Man back. Open fire on those idiots, rookie. We've got a superhero to save.
Is Bloke Man lost forever to the color-coordinated clutches of blow-dried metrosexuality? All will be revealed next week in our final episode when Bloke Man and Metrosexual Man finally get it on.